Today, I'll show you how to fuel a hydrogen car, like my Toyota Mirai. The MSRP for Toyota Mirai is $57,500 before any government incentives.
We have no hydrogen, so we're going to the hydrogen station. As you can see, we only have 18 miles left. And the light is on. Nearest hydrogen to us is in Anaheim, right at the 76. Let's go get hydrogen! I will drive up to the hydrogen station, which is in the back of the station where the grassy is.
Push the fuel button to open the fuel tank. Press the fuel tank door and it will pop open. Pull out the nozzle cover so you can insert the fueling nozzle. Put in your credit card. In my case, I used the $15,000 card Toyota gave me. Type in your zip code. When it finishes processing, then you are ready to begin. I leased my Mirai for 36 months for 12,000 miles a year. For the life of the lease, I will have paid nothing in fuel. How great is that? Toyota gives you $15,000 towards your hydrogen. Take the fueling nozzle like you would at a regular fuel station and plug it into the car's receptacle. Lock it in by squeezing the trigger handle. You will hear a click, letting you know it is safely in place. Oh, there is a condensation from the last person to fill up. Some stations have the option to pick between H35 and H70. This station only has H70, which is the right pressure I need for my Mirai. Once it starts, the machine will analyze and adjust the pressure needed to pump the car full of hydrogen. Once it's adjusted, it will start pumping on its own. Watch the numbers increase like a regular gas station. Bye-bye money. Oh wait, it's not my money going. Yeah, keep pumping. While we're waiting, let's throw you some facts. California has 27 hydrogen stations scattered around the state. They are also in the process of building more. According to the EPA, the car can go 312 miles on a full tank. But from my driving myself, I seem to only be able to drive about 260 miles. People always wonder if hydrogen is safe. One test involves firing bullets into the hydrogen tank. Pierced tanks typically vent their hydrogen so quickly that even if the fuel catches fire, it is out of the tank before it could ignite. Some hydrogen is made on-site at a fuel fueling station that uses a process to split the hydrogen molecules from water. The electricity for that process can come from either on-site solar panels or from the local electrical grid. Most hydrogen for fuel, however, is made in large hydrogen processing plants. The hydrogen is then trucked to the station and stored in a large above-ground tank. Oh, fueling is done! Let's take a look! I saved $65.70 today. Yay! Wow, look how cold it got! Ice from all over the nozzle! To remove it, all you need to do is press the button to release the safety lock and pull out the nozzle. Sometimes it gets stuck due to the ice buildup. It's okay, just give it a little elbow grease by popping it in and out. That's why it gets stuck. It looks like a popsicle. All done, just stick the cover back on and close the fuel cover. Watch it change from 17 miles left to 243. Wow, that's nowhere near the 312 they said I would get. Fueling took only 15 minutes. So why choose fuel cell vehicles? Electric vehicles tend to be small with limited range and long recharging time, whereas fuel cell vehicles are quick and easy to refill. They also are true zero emission vehicles and are clean as battery electric cars on the road. Thanks for watching my vlog on fueling and paying for fuel on my Mirai. I'm not being paid by Toyota, nor did I get a car to make this vlog. I just wanted to show people how easy it was compared to getting gas. Hopefully, this will educate and push people to support more environmentally friendly vehicles. This planet has given us so much, it's time to take care of it and give back to the planet. Vlogging next time, bye!